crossing to Mexico, and apparently I'm not supposed to report in the Mexican customs facility, but here it is. This is Mexico. I'm driving to Mexico. I'm gonna give you the pointers of how to have a successful trip, day trip in your vehicle into Mexico. Look at that flag. It's a big Mexican flag. I missed it so much. I have been crossing into Mexico without incident for years, and my experience has always been good, and I feel that I should share that with you so you have an enjoyable experience when you're in Mexico. Things to remember is no guns in Mexico. You're not allowed to bring guns into Mexico. You will get arrested at the border for bringing anything that is remotely related to guns, such as bullets or even magazines, bulletproof vests and all that. You cannot bring it into Mexico. Also remember, you need car insurance to drive into Mexico. Most likely the insurance you have doesn't cover you in Mexico. There's plenty of Mexican insurance places along the border as you drive into Mexico. So make sure you hit one of those for very cheap. You can have coverage for the weekend or even up to a year. There's customs laws that apply to you when you're going back into the United States for stuff that you cannot bring into the United States with you. Even stuff that is legal in the United States, such as produce and other items, you cannot bring them into the United States. To be on the safe side, make sure you declare everything that you brought with you from Mexico into the United States. Bring plenty of cash for your trip. Cash is king in Mexico. Even though you can pay with a credit card or ATM, you're better off not leaving your information on this side of the border. Bring cash and make sure you exchange dollars in the United States. Even though there's plenty of Mexican money exchange places on this side of the border, you may want to do it in the United States just to be safer. Also, empty your wallet. Don't bring any credit cards or ATMs. Bring it down to a minimum. Don't bring any IDs that you don't need in Mexico. Leave all that at home and then just bring one credit card, maybe one ATM, and as I said, cash for the day. The GPS on your car or your phone will not work in Mexico. So even though you see this, it's very inaccurate. I try to go by it and it takes me to different places. So it looks like it's working, but most likely it's not working or it's not accurate. So make sure you bring a paper map so that you don't get lost. Have you noticed that in Hollywood movies, everybody speaks English? Even aliens from other planets speak English. Well, this is not the case. In border towns such as Tijuana and Mexicali, there's people that speak English, but the vast majority do not. So don't expect people to speak English. So you may rely on things like Google Translate, but if you don't have an international data plan, most likely your phone will not have data and you won't be able to use your Google Translate. So bring the good old dictionary or one of those little books with commonly used phrases in Spanish. And that's about it. Make sure you hit a lot of these fine restaurants. There's plenty of fine restaurants along the border that come at a fraction of the cost of what you will pay in the United States for the same delicious food. There's plenty of doctors, a lot of dentists along the border. They speak English, they accept American insurance. One of the many things that you can do while in Mexico is enjoy delicious tacos. I just ran into the place that I used to come when I was a kid many, many years ago, and they were delicious. Let's check them out. Make the best of your day trip. There's plenty of points of interest along the border. There's Rosarito, which is a beach along the Pacific Ocean. There's San Felipe, which is a small fishing town with a lot of sand dunes and desert parks to go off-roading. You can fish, you can off-road, you can do all the things, you can camp out. There's plenty of campsites in San Felipe. That's about 2 hours from the border. And there's Rosarito. There's also Ensenada. In between Rosarito and Ensenada, the local wineries with beautiful scenery. I hope I covered everything. I hope you had a great time watching my video. Please subscribe, please comment, please like my video. My name is Juan Carlos.
Hasta la próxima.